Morning, Bambinos. Did your mum miss me? I bet she did. Today we are doing part two of dialogue. And it got delayed because, well, it isn't perfect yet. So it's going to be a longish video and I will try not to muck about. I've had a few more constructive criticisms and I'll take them on board and try to improve delivery so that you are a happy customer. What we are talking about today is infinite talk, and we will use it with Uni3C or UniAnimate or Fantasy Portrait, and in that order, the workflow provides each of those. But to be clear, we do not use them all at the same time. All of them use infinite talk, but only by themselves. And I should say about this episode that this is a journey through different attempts and not a one-stop solution. If you want a one-stop solution, then probably watch something else, but you'll learn a bit about each of them by watching this, so it's up to you. You may have noticed this is absolutely improved audio, and that is because, well, I improved the audio slightly. The vibe voice I am using is from enemyxs-net, and if you want that, seek it out on GitHub. It is fantastic. MIT license, but with caveats, of course. I began my research wanting to test infinite talk with Uni3C, but made a huge mistake. I thought it would work with open pose to animate the person. It doesn't. It works with control nets to move the camera. But UniAnimate should indeed work with poses, but it uses its own. So my entire foray into Blender was a bit of a waste of time. Or was it? Anyway, what you're looking at is... God, you must be bored of seeing this shot, because I am, but... We are nearing the end of this period of research, and I see no good reason to not use it. What we are looking at it is the reference image I used to test infinite talk first, with Uni3C, then with UniAnimate, and finally with Fantasy Portrait. And I will now talk you through each. Let's start with Uni3C, because that was what I began with, and what I made the Blender-based animation for, thinking I could convert this to this open pose, and then try the Uni3C result. My mistake was not realizing that Uni3C is for camera motion, and any people motion is incidental. So this produced...
I was just saying, I mean, the 60s was a different time.
It's not very good. I think you'll agree, but every failure is a lesson. And from this we learn what? We learn that Uni3C without proper camera motion will stop everything moving. You never know when that might come in useful. Put it in the back pocket for a rainy day. But it wasn't what we were after, and I didn't try fixing it for Uni3C, but I might in a future video dedicated to camera motion. Maybe. Instead, I took what I had and threw it at UniAnimate. Or planned to. What I realized was that UniAnimate already had a way of converting video of people moving to open pose using its own node. Ho-hum. Time wasted in Blender, but no matter. Go in and bear it and get on. So I put the Blender animation bodge 3D model into UniAnimate, and it created this pose with two pointy stick things for their head position. And from that, I got this.
Didn't he set that other bird off that time?
Of course, because it literally took what I gave it in the pose control, which was this. And let's look at the result again, because it is so weird.
Didn't he set that other bird off that time?
Now, if you watched the Blender tutorial before this one, I claimed that any animator did it.
Didn't he set that other bird off that time?
Yes, I was wrong. I forgot, because I had done so many damn tests that in fact nothing I did would work with any animator to stop this happening.
Didn't he set that other bird off that time?
Mr. Terminator Head! Now, this isn't to say UniAnimate isn't any good. It's very good. But you need to provide the pose for it to work too. And that includes providing the let's call it humanness, for want of a better word. Same with Uni3C, which wants camera motion, movement. UniAnimator wants you to give it the pose it will use. I thought I could trick it by reducing strength, and maybe infinite talk would take over, but even with strength 0.1, it still did it. Other people have done a better job of showing UniAnimate than me, and since this isn't a use case I really need, it was time to move on. Let's look at Fantasy Portrait with infinite talk. But before I do, let's talk about what goes into the infinite talk workflow, which I have provided for you in the link for free. Download that and have a butcher's. In this workflow, you can see a few areas bypassed. This is the infinite talk workflow with Uni3C in the top right, UniAnimator down the bottom, Fantasy Portrait in the top middle. We'll talk about the other bits in more detail now, beginning with the models. Here is the model loading section. The main model I use is Magref, and I use it because it is an I2V model, that is image to video, and like Phantom, it is very good at maintaining consistency, usually. I had some problems in this workflow, as I mentioned elsewhere, and losing consistency when the talking head moved left to right or vice versa was one of them. Rather than bore you with the ins and outs of that, I will simply say that what you are looking at in the mobile section fixed it for the most part. I have reduced LoRAs because of it. I do not use the Lite X2 eLoRa here because it was part of that problem. But curiously, the fast one works fine, and since that gives us speed, I use it. The infinite talk model is there, as you can see. And the other bypass one is the UniAnimate model, which gets switch in and out as required. The other one that isn't showing there, but you can see it, plugged into the main model slot, is the Fantasy Portrait model, and we will discuss that shortly. You'll also find a ton of notes in this workflow, I will probably leave them in for you. Some might no longer be relevant. It might help if you run into problems. Some of you might have noticed something strange in this model loader. See it? Radial Sage Attention is what I'm referring to. It's a new thing I tried during tests, and it worked to shave a minute off each 6 minutes of process time, so I'm curious to test it in other workflows. Remember, AI is constantly evolving, so things change from day to day in this game. Get used to it. Now let's talk about the audio section, and the audio clip is what drives Infinite Talk to make the lips move. I have noticed it struggles a bit with things like bees. It sometimes doesn't close the mouth properly. One trick I figured out for this is to use Audacity to push the audio clip to a maximum 0.0 normalization. It's not a perfect solution, but it helps. So whether you are using Uni3C or UniAnimate or Fantasy Portraits or even just Infinite Talk on its own, then you will want to plug either one of the neon colored routers in to the audio slot or the audio clip loader direct in, or the case of Infinite Talk, on its own. The same will be the case for the sampler, where color coded routers will enable you to pick and choose between Uni3C, UniAnimate, or Fantasy Portrait. Or just unplug them all for Infinite Talk on its own. I have a super loud colored radial node there, because that is what I do when I'm testing a node. It helps me remember I have added it in when I get called away and come back and wonder what the hell I was working. Now, something different here is that Infinite Talk no longer uses context option window to run, well, infinitely. Kijai has worked his magic, and on up-to-date Comfy UI setups it now is needed. Instead, we drive it using the audio clip or audio within the video clip. For this reason, we set frames to win. We have 1,000. And just let the workflow decide how long it goes.
A slight drawback to this is that Infinite Talk now works in audio indices blocks. That is, we'll do 81 frames, the next block is 153 frames, the next block 225 frames, and so on. I don't recall the exact number, but this means it will pad the end if you break into a new block but don't have enough frames. Fine, but also a little annoying when time is a consideration. Just something to be aware of.
You can see all the information in the command window. Another thing is that radial attention doesn't work less than 768 by 512. And for me, working in 16x9 aspect ratio, that equates to what you see there, which is 910x512. Not a big deal, because the higher resolution you go, the better the lip sync quality. Which stands to reason. I will make a future video about increasing resolution if I need to figure that out. For now, I will be going with what you see there. My use case is that I probably won't need anything much longer than 10 seconds for dialogue before a shot changes position to another camera angle. Now, before we move on to discussing Fantasy Portrait, I will clarify how I did this one.
Didn't he set that other bird off that time?
I mistakenly said in the last video on Blender that it was done using UniAnimator. It wasn't. This was actually just Infinite Talk on its own with better prompting to direct look. Where normally I just used a man talking. This time I used a man turns his head to talk to the two men on the right. The men listened to him without moving. It also had normalized audio, which I had fixed in Audacity. So finally we come to Fantasy Portrait running with Infinite Talk. I had hoped this would be the ultimate lip sync, and I could record myself on my Android phone and then act and speak my way to lip sync and pose perfection. The problem was, takes a lot more work than I want to put into it. So I will be going with just Infinite Talk with good prompting when I start my next project. Only because of the time factor, I will be honest. Well, that and because I can't act. I thought having a big bushy beard would be the problem, but it wasn't. Because Fantasy Portrait has a fantastic face landmarking system, and it can fake the line of my chin, despite not knowing where it is, because of a Darwin-sized beard that I currently sport. But let's now use that Reservoir Dogs clip that you surely recognised. And with my man for a reference image, this is what we ended up getting.
I mean, I'm very sorry the government taxes their tips. That ain't my fault. I mean, it would appear that waitresses are one of the many groups the government on a regular basis. I mean, if you show me a piece, I mean, I'm very sorry the government taxes their tips. That ain't my fault. I mean, it would appear that waitresses are one of the many groups.
Here is an interesting thing that I just realized while putting this together in Da Vinci Resolve that I had planned to look at later. I noticed that my guy froze halfway through his speech, and I didn't understand what had happened. Now, I think I do. Let's just look at that again once more, but note two things. Firstly, my man stops moving his head. And secondly, that the video of Reservoir Dogs has stopped playing when he does, but the audio continues.
I mean, I'm very sorry the government taxes their tips. That ain't my fault. I mean, it would appear that waitresses are one of the many groups the government on a regular basis. I mean, if you show me a piece...
If you'll indulge me, what you are getting now is me live troubleshooting this. But I think I know the problem, so let me just go find those two files to show you. Here is the inbound video, and it is running at 16 frames per second.
I mean, I'm very sorry the government taxes their tips. That ain't my fault. I mean, it would appear that waitresses are one of the many groups the government on a regular basis. I mean, if you show me a piece...
And here is the outbound face landmarker video that is running at 25 frames per second.
I mean, I'm very sorry the government taxes their tips. That ain't my fault. I mean, it would appear that waitresses are one of the many groups...
Because Infinite Talk is a 25 frames per second workflow. Something I forgot to mention earlier, but in my tests, always 25 frames per second produced the best results. Problem is likely in the settings I red circled here, where I have let the inbound remain as 16 frames per second, but as a result, it's only 161 frames. If I set that to 25 frames per second on the inbound, it switches it to 249 frames. I didn't tell you that initially, because I wasn't sure of the effect it would have, but I am going to do that now and see if it resolves the problem.
I mean, I'm very sorry the government taxes their tips. That ain't my fault. I mean, it would appear that waitresses are one of the many groups the government on a regular basis. I mean, if you show me a piece...
And so I was correct. We need to put 25 FPS in the inbound video, or at least make sure the length will match up in terms of frames. I probably should have taken it into shortcut and interpolated it properly there, but it was worth a gamble here just to see what happened. And of course, it saves a bit of time. The end result, since I ran it live, I can show you the command window now. And also, since we are here, that on the right is my memory processor that I watched the GPU RAM and swap file action from. And you can see as it drifts away that it was blapping the GPU a bit. I talk about that in my video on memory tricks, and what you are seeing there is tipping close to the point I might have stopped the workflow and looked for ways to improve it, but I knew it would run, so left it. You can also see the audio batch segments on the left screen, and there the frame count and the time it took to complete. The message about not enough SMs to use max autotune I see occasionally, and usually relates to the fact I'm using a 3060 card, but seems not to be a problem, so I ignore it here. One thing this did make me think was that I didn't show you the way Fantasy Portrait needed to be plugged in to the sampler, which is a little more fiddly than Uni3C or UniAnimate, so just be aware of it. It needs to look like that. I've run it before without plugging that in, and 30 minutes later want to throw the PC out the window, so double check it before you double wreckety wreck yourself. That's a 90s say, probably said badly. But I do like Fantasy Portrait with Infinite Talk, and as you can see, it runs 10 seconds no problem in 30 minutes on my machine, a 3060 12GB VRAM. What more could I want? Acting skills. Well, I guess we can't have everything. Maybe I will use this workflow, which we'll see. But let's watch one more time as we play out and see how it matches the original or uses it, even though it is sat in the exact same spot as the speaker in the original video. That is pretty cool.
I mean, I'm very sorry the government taxes their tips. That ain't my fault. I mean, it would appear that waitresses are one of the many groups the government on a regular basis. I mean, if you show me a...
And that's it for this video. I will be doing my new 720p FFLF, first frame, last frame video, in a few days, all things being equal. And now I will go back through this video and beep out the swear words, because I am a socially responsible kind of guy, and kids might enjoy watching this. Meows or owl hoots, I haven't yet decided. Let's see. Till next time. Ciao, bambinos.